Hi children, welcome back. Okay, in this video we are going to discuss about the next topic, that is adaptation in the animals. Already in the previous videos we have learnt about adaptation in the plants, how they have adapted themselves to the different climate and all. Okay, now in this lesson we will learn about the adaptation of the animals in the different areas. So we know already what is habitat, we know already what is adaptation, what is habitat, we know already the natural environment where the naturally the animals or plants are going to live. And this adaptation means the special character feature of the particular animal or a plant, how it is adopted itself or it is made itself to adjust its own climate. For example, about the plants also we have learned, the terrestrial plants, aquatic plants we have learned, and terrestrial means on land. On the land, different types of the lands are there. I mean, the climate is changing different area. Then how do in those areas the plants have adopted? We have learned these all. The same we are learning about the animals. So again, adaptation means what? Where do we see the plants? We see the plants on the land, in the water, on the ice, on the ice snowfall region. The same wise we see even the plants also there and animals also there. So in this lesson we will learn about the animals. For example, again we have some differentiated the nature or our environment or this earth into some region. For example, first one is terrestrial, second one is aerial, third one is aquatic, arboreal. So, like this we have divided. Then even the animals are also going to live on terrestrial, that is on land. Many types of animals we see on the land, and then there are many others are there. The animals and the birds are there, they live on the air. In the air they spend most of the time in the air. Those animals are called as the aerial animals. Most of the birds will live in the air, they will spend their life in the air. So first we will see it one by one, adaptation in the animals. First we will go to the terrestrial part. Terrestrial means what? On the land. Then how many types of animals we can see which live on the land. Again, on land we have different lands. For example, there is a normal land where we are living, our climate, isn't it? We also live here in this Karnataka, and next in another state they have different feature of the climate. And even in the Rajasthan also they live, they have adjusted themselves to that climate. So like this, the land, piece of land or the variety of land, climate changes from one place to another. Normal land, we can see dog, cat, donkey, horse, many animals around us. Just now around us we can see many animals, they are living with us and they have normally adjusted to the surrounding, that place. Then desert, we know how the desert will be, very hot place. Next, ice region. Now let us see one by one. See children, on the land, as I told you, there are many animals. They will live normally. They have not adjusted themselves. So, they have not adjusted how normally we are living. Even the climate is also normal in the normal land. And they will live as usual. The horse, dog, cat, and other animals. Many pet animals are there. Wild animals are there. And domestic animals are there. They have adjusted themselves and they are living with us. So this is very simple. Next, desert. We will see some special features in the desert. There are some animals, especially the camel. Camel is going to live on the desert. Desert means it is filled with a lot of sand. Sand means, and even the climate will be very hot. There is no amount of water and there is no greenery. Only we can see some types of plants like cactus, aloe vera, the very thick, as we have discussed in the previous videos. Only few, and very few points will be there. There we will get a very small amount of water. And then the camel, it has to live in the desert because it is known as the sheep of the desert. And then it has to adjust itself to the desert, to live on the desert. Then how it has adjusted? See, if I start from the leg part of the camel, we can see that these toes are joined. In the leg part, there are toes. Our toes are different. Fingers are different. There is a lot of space between these fingers and even the toes also. But the camel toes is joined like this. So, they can prevent to sink inside the soil. So, they can run very fast in the soil. And even bottom part of the feet is so hard so that it cannot get lot of heat to its body, and even its skin is also very leathery, so it that can protect its whole body from the sun hot. And you can see the eyes of the camel, they have very long eye lashes. The hair on these eyes are very long and thick, because there will be always wind, and along with the wind as the soil is there, the soil is also will come. So there are many possibilities of to go inside the eyes of the camel. The soil may go inside the eyes. So those long eye hair or eye slashes are going to protect the camel. Even if you see the mouth part of the camel, so inside there is a broad and very leather, thick leather, strong leather part is there, layer is there inside the mouth. So whatever the plants that is going to eat are very thorny, means you know needle like will be there. Cactus, aloe vera, they have needle like structure on their leaf, so it is going to eat that one. So while eating those needle like a very sharp thorny like structure, they should not hurt its mouth. So that mouth is made up of a very hard layer of the leather. So like this, these are the simple body parts, but these are very much important and special to that camel, to adjust it, that camel itself to the desert. So this is how the special adaptation of the camel to adjust in the desert. Then we have the ice region. So in the ice region also we can see many type of the animals, like dog we can see, ice dogs we can call them, and the bears, especially bears we can see, white color bears will be there, black color bears will be there. How do the bears appear? How the bears are there to look? We know that they have very long and thick hair, they look very cute. Why they have? Because in the ice region, how the climate will be? That the opposite of this desert, here very hot and here very cold. Even we cannot survive there if we go without sweaters and all, we cannot survive. But these animals like bears and all, no, those animals, they don't have any clothes to wear, they don't have any socks and shoes to wear. They have to adjust their bodies, they have adopted their bodies such that they can live easily in the ice regions. On the body part of the bear, they have the long and thick hair. Those hairs are going to protect the bear from the outside cold climate. And then you can see its feet. The feet of the bear is made up of again very thick leather. The skin is very thick, so it can skate easily. It should not sink inside the ice. Those are made up of very thick, and they have the sharp eyes too, and sharp smelling nose, a sharp smelling character, so that they can smell the food and they can go and eat. This is how some of the animals, they have adjusted themselves to the different regions on the land. So we have discussed very less animals in the normal, on the normal land, but we have many type of the normal animals on the normal land. See children, even snake lives on the land, frog lives on the land, and some animals, as I told you, cow, buffalo, wild animals, or that those may be domestic animals, they all live on the land. Let us see this example of the snake. Snake is different, right? Then other animals have the leg, so they can move, run, isn't it? But snake is not at all having legs, any legs. Then how do the snakes move? We know that there are number of scales on the snake's body. That those scales will help snake to move. The snake is not having bone in the body, but it has to move. It has very soft body, but those scales will help snake to move. This is how the snake has adjusted. Even though the body shape of the snake is totally different from the other snake, sorry, other animals, but the snake, how do snake will move? Those scales will help to move in on the land. And frogs, we have two legs and two hands for the frog. And even other than that, other animals like horse, donkey, they have four legs. They can run easily. They can walk easily. They have the mouth and eyes, nose, everything they have. So this is how the animals around us will live on the land. And even what about the wild animals? Wild animals like tiger, lion, cheetah, elephant, giraffe. You can see how they are living. See, tiger, a lion, cheetah, these are called as the wild animals. They are living in the forest. Then the cave is their house. They will take shelter under the cave. Then what is their food? They don't have the food how we eat. They will go and just kill the other animals and they will eat whenever they feel hungry. Then to run very faster, they have the capacity of running. And to tear the skin of the other animals after killing, they have the sharp nails, sharp teeth, and their skin is just, it looks like a how the grass color is, how the land color is, how do the skin of the cheetah and lion will be, just like it looks like a land. So they can confuse the other animals and then they can chase and they can go and kill that animal. So this is the characteristics of the lion which they are going to hunt. And what about the deer and other animals? You can see how the tortoise, it has legs. But if sudden some danger comes or something is there on the tortoise, or some animals is keeping leg on the tortoise, you might have seen. You disturb the tortoise which is there in the well. Okay, if you disturb, suddenly it will take its leg inside and even the neck inside. This is how the tortoise is going to adjust, and its shell becomes very hard. Even the big lorry passes on that, the shell will be, that tortoise inside the tortoise will be safe. So this is how it is going to adjust itself. And even some deer and some other animals which are going to be hunted by the wild animals, even they are having the skin which is just like a leaf or a tree color. They have, even snakes also, they have the capacity of changing the color of the skin, isn't it? I don't know, you might have learned this one or not, but like this they have adjusted. Some other animals, deer and some other animals, deer, goat, some other animals, cow, they want to save themselves from the hunting animals, whereas hunting animals, they want to hunt the animals to eat. So like this, there will be an adjustment, there will be the adaptation, how these are going to adopted in their natural, sorry, in their environment or in their surrounding places. This is how the terrestrial animals have adopted themselves in the different region, that is normal land, maybe there desert, maybe there, and the ice region maybe there. So in the next video we will discuss about the aerial animals, aquatic animals and all. Okay children, I hope you all have understood whatever we have discussed today in this video, and just try to write down all the reasons of the terrestrial part, and try to write minimum about two animals, how they have adjusted, adopted themselves. I hope you will do this homework, and let us discuss the next part in the next video. Till then, take care, bye bye.